Michael from Red Chair Diaries from my living room, Nova Scotia, Canada, and I'm going to talk about Boogie Nights for this retrospect. This is such a good movie. This is the second time I've seen it in its entirety. I saw it there once again. Ted and I went to the movies to see this when it came out in 1997. In those days, Ted and I used to go to movies. Don't want to move around too much. Say hello, newbie. Say hello. Anyway, what a fantastic movie. It operates on several levels. It ostensibly, it's about the pornography industry, the movie industry before the real widespread adoption of VHS tapes in the early 80s. So this takes place, this starts in 1977. The winds of change are in the air. And the protagonist in the piece is Mark Wahlberg as a character who ends up, Eddie, who adopts the porno name of Dirk Diggler. It actually is quite a good name for a porn guy. So what you, and you've got Burt Reynolds, who's the director, Jack Horner of, you know, the porns, and you've got all these people in there like William H. Macy as a, he's like a technician who's always being cuckolded by his wife. There's a wonderful line where he finds her having sex twice with strangers, you know, and he's really, really disturbed by this, like in his own bed and at a one of the parties that's going on. She's having sex in the driveway and all these men are standing around watching her having sex, and he comes over and says, "What the fuck are you doing?" And she says, "Go away, you're embarrassing me." Fantastic line. So you've got Julianne Moore, one of my top five favorite actresses, giving a wonderful role as Amber Waves, and she's doing too many drugs, but she, which of course causes trouble. She's never going to get her son back because of what she's doing. So you've got, everybody has a story. Don Cheadle kind of has a weird cowboy persona, I guess, in his adult films. But his real love is stereo, you know, like a stereo salesman. You've got Philip Seymour Hoffman. This may be the first time I saw him. Was he in Twister, and I don't know when Twister came out, if it was before or after this, but he's a frustrated homosexual in this. He's got the hots for Dirk Diggler, and the feelings are not returned. Dirk Diggler is not gay. He's a straight porn star. And I think one of the most touching roles in this is the Philip Seymour Hoffman one, because he really does convey that longing and then that embarrassment of being so needy, you know. It's actually quite touching, and I've seen that on people, that sort of frustration. I mean, we've all had crushes, but you know, I mean, I've had crushes, but I've had people when I was younger crushing on me, and it wasn't going to happen. It's very similar to the Philip Seymour Hoffman character, you know, and it's. You know, it can be heartbreaking, that's for sure. This is directed by, is it Paul Thomas Anderson? PTA, I think Cineram calls him. The movie is wonderfully directed. It's directed, like, technically, as in the actors are doing a wonderful job. So, you know, they're being directed, besides, of course, using their innate talent. But I think it's beautifully photographed as well. And all of the whole design of the movie, I can tell you, is very authentic, because I am very, very familiar with 1977 to 1983, which is the span of this movie, maybe even 84. You know, I was a young lad. I mean, 1977, I was 25, and 1983, I would have turned 32. So, you know, I'm certainly familiar with that. I'm not all that familiar with pornography, believe it or not, because I never bought any. I mean, besides, you know, going into a store, maybe looking through some magazines. And gay porn doesn't seem to be part of these movies that they're making there, from what I can see. I've never actually owned a pornographic tape. And now with all of the internet porn, this is a part of American culture, North American culture, that younger people will have no knowledge of. Because why would you? It's all on the net. You can pay for it by the minute or, subscription basis. And then there's all that amateur porn on the net as well. So, everything is topsy-turvy these days. Anyway, to get back to the movie and move away from these sociological comments, the art direction, as I said, was wonderful because of the disco soundtrack, fantastic dance to an awful lot of those songs. The clothes, the sort of like block color shirts that Dirk Diggler was wearing quite a bit. And just terrific, just terrific stuff. I must say though, Dirk Diggler at one point had what may very well be the ugliest bathing suit ever, a Speedo type. And it was, I don't mind those, I like those, but the colors were just, it was the ugliest thing. I mean, Mark Wahlberg, he's one of those short, compact bodies, and he can look good in anything like that, but he sure didn't look good in this. And that was the intention of the scene, I'm sure. It was just ugly fashion, that particular item. I don't know what else to say about it because, like I said, it was operating on all kinds of levels with the examination of the industry, and it follows conventions about show business. Hopes and dreams, and some dreams being dashed. That sort of story we've seen many times, but not in this particular milieu of entertainment. And it's mostly benign as we go through it. We've got all these characters with their own heartaches, but the tone shifts completely in that last half hour, and there's a lot of violence in that last half hour. Pardon me, there's parts of it that reminded me of the end of True Romance, even a little bit of Scarface, the remake. But in the end, most of the characters came out okay. Most of them. Not all of them survived the 70s. I can tell you that. But Burt Reynolds did a wonderful job in this. I think he was nominated in this for this movie, but he did a wonderful job as the father figure and the director. John C. Reilly, not one of the best looking men in Hollywood, but he inhabits his character so well. His character was a porn actor. Thank goodness we didn't get to see him do anything. But he brings such an authenticity of like naivety to these characters. I was thinking about his role in What's Eating Gilbert Grape, where he was really looking forward to opening up a Bob's Burger franchise or working at Bob's Burger, and that was, and he was again somebody who seemed to be quite naive about the way of the world, and in this, considering he's in the porno industry, he's also a bit naive and marginally stupid in both of these movies, I think. But I think very authentic. I thought he was wonderful in this. Now I see a bunch of the faces on TV there. Julianne Moore, fantastic. Mark Wahlberg, I could take him or leave him in anything. I'm not a big fan of his, but it's not like he did a bad job by any means. And then the supporting actors, I don't remember their names, a lot of them. I think I mentioned just about everybody. So, for those of you who were really young, it's a good, this is a good history lesson movie, and you'll get a charge out of the clothes and things like that. This is what I call a cell phone free movie, because there's no cell phones, there's no internet, there's no DVDs, you know, and so activities move at the speed of actual personal interaction, you see? You know, so it's directed kind of like that too. But, you know, the universal themes for people, you know, have aspirations that they can't achieve because they hold themselves back with things like, well, I'm making porno movies, I'm going to be a big star. I'm making porno movies, I'm going to get my daughter back and stop taking drugs. Well, you're in the middle year, it's pretty hard to get out of that, I would think. I don't have a lot of experience. I've never been addicted to drugs. I'm not even addicted to alcohol. I drink everything in moderation. Well, maybe I'm addicted to it in a moderate manner. But the, you know, cocaine, I've never even been near cocaine. I've never been anywhere near it. So that sort of world view I don't have. But I do think this was quite authentic that way. But in this movie, as in just about every other movie and in real life, drugs like that inevitably lead to trouble, real trouble, because you can't sustain a run-of-the-mill or a middle-of-the-road or a mainstream quality of life if that's what you're doing. It just doesn't last, anyway, from what I can understand. Anyway, I don't know if I have all that much more to say. I just really, really liked it. But it's a movie about the pornography industry, but the movie itself is not pornographic in any way, shape, or form. You might see some women's breasts and some men's rear ends, but you don't, you know, there's everything else is just inferred. So don't be put off by it. And also don't be put off by one of the ugliest posters and ever. This is so poorly conceived, I think, as actually showing what the movie is about. It looks like some weird cartoon or something, you know. I don't like that at all. I never did care for that cover. I mean, the script is from the 70s and 80s, the typeface, the font, whatever. And the colors might be, but I think it does a disservice. There are some better posters I've seen on the net, maybe for reissues or maybe at the movies themselves. Anyway, this is the third movie I watched today on my day off so that I wouldn't get behind. So I only have one more to watch, and this month will be over because this is going out in 2 days' time. Anyway, Michael from Red Chair Diaries, and I do recommend Boogie Nights, but you have to pay close attention to it. It is a mature movie, but it's not a dirty movie. And I will see you around the tube.